guys, and welcome back to my channel. As you can see, my hair is a mess, which means that we're gonna be trying another hairstyle out. I washed my hair, I put no product in it, I kind of just let it dry, which now has resulted into a knotted mess because I didn't do the hairstyle. Last month I tried knotless braids for the first time and I felt confused watching the footage myself. I kept getting questions asking me if there was ever going to be like a video on those braids, and no, because I don't want to confuse you. You're going to watch it and just be like, as you know, I'm not a professional. I kind of just try things and try to simplify it to my understanding as a beginner to show you what I'm doing. So it's not really a tutorial, but anyways. I changed shirts. I have a shirt on just in case. It's hot. So, I have the viewfinder, but it's really hard to see myself. So I moved in this weird position so that I can see myself better in the mirror that I have here. I know that I want a middle part. So, alright, if you've been following me for a while, you know that I love like the messy look. I don't really go for very neat partings. The messier, the better, kind of, because it looks more natural. People legitimately think that these braids are growing out of my hair and that I, or out of my head, and that I have like these really super long braids and twists, and I'm just like, overnight though, like, what I did was that I went from the middle of my head down to the back of my ear. And as for the back, I kind of just like, split it in half with my fingers. Now this back part, you do want it to be pretty full because you don't want like the back of your head to look with like a lot of gaps and spaces. I'm gonna have about 4 braids on the top, which is like this first line here. Okay, so this is how I do it. Again, I'm not a professional. First, I'm gonna grab some product, your styling cream or gel, whatever it is that you want to sort of control over your hair so that it's more like manageable. And the first thing I'm gonna do, I found it's easier for me to start braiding up, right, because I'm doing it on myself. So I'm just gonna braid this up. So I'm braiding my own natural hair upwards. Okay, so now we're here. I'm doing it pretty tightly so that the braid is going to be closer to my scalp. And I'm gonna stop at the position where I'm gonna go ahead and pull some hair over again. But instead of continuing, I'm gonna stop there. I'm gonna grab some hair and I'm going to feed that into the middle leg of my braid. And I'm gonna pull this, the rest of the hair, up. Put that to the side, and then I'm going to continue braiding. And you want to do it in this position here because of this leg of the braid is going to sort of like cover and seal that in. And then what you can do is, once you're in this position, then I'm going to go ahead and pull this over to be the middle leg of the braid. I'm going to pull the hair and add it to that leg of the braid and keep braiding. Now I'm here again in this position where I'm about to pull the farthest leg of this braid over the middle piece, right? I'm gonna grab the hair, feed it to the middle leg, pull that back, grab my strand here, pull it over the middle, keep braiding. Now, usually people add in a third, like feed-in piece of hair, but I don't wanna do that. And so what I'm doing here is just adding this hair to that leg, and I'm just going to keep braiding. And that's not how you normally do it. When I do it, you can't really tell. The braid doesn't look too weird, you know? And now, because this part is pretty tight, it's nice, it's not pulling on my baby hairs, by the way. You can see that it looks pretty okay. It looks fine. Once I already have that secure, you can continue braiding, and I braid a little looser so that my braid just appears a little more thicker. Of course, if I add more hair, I don't have to do that, but split, for example, split some of this hair here and give that strand some more hair so that it's not too thin. If that makes sense, it's kind of up to you. I'm going to make this one by my face. So I'm just gonna go ahead and add like one of these little black rubber bands. Now, of course, you're gonna end up with this, and that's not what you want. So I'll show you when I'm done what I do to get that crimped wavy look. I'm gonna show you a second method, which is more of like a cheating illusion that it's a knotless braid. It requires no feed-in. I feel like for the back of my head, I'm gonna end up doing this method of the braid that I'm gonna show you because I can't see. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take the piece of hair and you're going to take your fake hair here and apply it under, see that, under the section, and you're gonna use your real hair as the middle leg of the braid. So you're just gonna start braiding as you go here by adding the fake hair under. You get rid of the little knot that you usually get. You see that the section there has no knot. Of course, if I flip it, the knot is there. Either way, if you pull it to the side, it still looks pretty good. I feel like this is the quickest way. Guys, and this is the final look. You see it's nice and crimped, looking like this. I'm gonna do a little side part moment there, and this is the final look. I really hope you guys learned something and that you give it a try. If you do, please let me know, tag me if you can. If not, it's cool, it's all good. But yeah, anyways, that is all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next video.